Hello, ladies and gentlemen, how are you? I trust you are doing better than yesterday and since the last time that I made a video, despite all this craziness that's happening around us. Let's talk about face masks, in case that you decide to buy a face mask to protect you from the pathogens in the environment. What type to buy? I'm gonna say a little bit about the filtration mechanism, how they work, and you will learn actually that very small particles as well, they can be filtered out. And then the difference between a surgical mask and respirators, and what is the best one that you need to buy in order to be protected, in case that you decide to buy a face mask. Let's start. I have two different types of masks, the surgical mask and the respirators, but before going to see the differences, let's start with the filtration mechanisms, how they work. So, we do have the very small particles that actually they fit to pass through, but they will be filtered out, and they will be filtered out because they are so small, and the filter media, they have electrostatic charges. So as they passing through, the electrostatic charges, they will attract them, and they are so small and light that they will be attracted. Also, very small particles, they are doing these Brownian moves, as they called, which is random moves in the air, and as they are passing, although they are going, let's say, to go through the space of the media, the empty space, actually, due to these random moves, they will hit the filter fibers and they will filter it out. So very small particles, they will be filtered out by these two filtration mechanisms. Then, of course, we have the bigger particles, which are like bacteria, dust, fungus, spores, which, due to their size, mechanically, they don't fit to pass through. And then we have the other particles, which they have a size called in the filter industry most penetrating particle size, which, yes, they fit to pass through. They are heavy enough and big enough not to be attracted from electrostatic forces, and they are not doing the Brownian moves. And sometimes they will pass through, sometimes due to a random position, okay, the impaction as it's called, it will hit the fibers and they will not pass through. But other times, they will pass through. And unfortunately, the viruses are in this category, in this size, which is the most penetrating particle size. In the next scene, you're going to see a comparison about the particle sizes. Okay, we have the biological viruses, allergens, bacteria, pollen, okay, we see the different viruses and the different particles, and the virus, as we see, it's between 20, 30 to 100 nanometer or up to 0.1 micrometers. And when they will pass, sometimes they will be filtered out, sometimes they will pass. And when they will pass, as you have seen in this video, which I had included in the virus-like silica nanoparticles, mimetic, fake viruses, just from silica. When the envelope virus, they will enter in our respiratory system and they reach our cells, the key from the envelope of the virus match with the lock of the membrane of the cell, because they have the same substance, cholesterol proteins. They will, the genes of the virus, they will come inside, they will infect us, they will multiply, and as they are going out, they acquire again part of the membrane, and they create their envelope, and then they're going out to find the new host. As we saw, we have four mechanisms that they are filtering particles, and despite the fact that some particles are very small and they are small enough to pass through the filtration, still they are filtered out due to the electrostatic charges or the Brownian moves, okay, the diffusion. The bigger particles, of course, they don't fit to pass, so they will stay out. And then the most penetrating particle size, particles that are having this size, sometimes they will be filtered out, sometimes they will not. And in order to, let's say, to protect ourselves, we need to wear a mask for the airborne pathogens. But which one? Surgical or respirator? Let's see. The surgical mask, and here pay attention. The surgical masks are not designed to protect you from the pathogen of the environment. They are designed, it's by design, to protect the environment from what will come out from the wearer. Point one. Second, they have very bad fit. They don't fit nicely around the face. And there's a lot of air, a lot of leakage. It can pass through the sides, up and down. So pathogens in the environment, they can pass through that, through the leakage. So they have very bad, poor face fit. And then as well, the filtration media is not designed to filter viruses. It's designed to filter bacteria. And they are getting the certification as a medical device if it can filter some bacteria that are required from the standard. And they can have as well the splash resistance, which is okay, an additional requirement in the additional category in the medical device standard, which actually it's protect. It has to demonstrate that in case that there are body fluids splashed from the patient on the mask, they will stay there and not going to go on the face or on the skin or inside the mouth and the nose of the wearer. As a result, the face masks, yes, they have a very good breathability, but they have very bad filtration and very bad face fit. And this is not the right product for you. On the other hand, we have the respirators, which, yes, they have a better fit. They are designed by design to protect the wearer from the contamination from the particles in the environment. They have a better fit. They have a thicker filtration, so they have much better filtration than the surgical masks, but they suffer in breathability due to the fact that it's very good fit and all the air has to pass through the filter media, and the filter media is thick relatively and complicated to block the pathogens. The air as well is not passing easily. We have different standards, but there are equivalents. In North America, according to the NIOSH, we have N95, N98, N99, which is just the level of filtration that is required, but they are tested with a salt, a specific size, or 98 or 99%. In Europe, we have the equivalent FFP1, FFP2, FFP3. The equivalent of F95 is FFP2, okay? And the equivalent to N99 is FFP3. And then we have the Australian standard, which is the models that are called P1, P2, P3. This is very similar to the European. And we have as well the Japanese standard, which is called the models that are called DS1, DS2, DS3, and has combined both North American and the European standard and some additional local requirements that they have in Japan. The performance parameter, yes, it's the filtration, it's the face fit, and the breathability. All the respirators, they are suffering in breathability. Yes, there are respirators that they do have a better breathability, but usually these are more expensive. But it's worth it, it makes really your life much easier. You can wear it up to 8 hours. Breathing, yes, you're gonna feel a little bit warm here, but you can breathe. And here just a comparison of the two, the main standards, the NIOSH and the FFP2. So bottom line is we have different surgical masks which are okay to protect the environment from what's coming out from the wearer. It can offer some protection from body fluids if they were splashed on the face of the wearer and they go to the mask. But they do not protect the wearer from the contagious environment. For this, you need actually a respirator. We have different types of respirator. It can be a folded one like this, a duck shape. It can be a cap, and you will see respirators with a valve. This they don't offer any additional filtration. This is simply to help with the breathability. We will see there are respirators that there are simply certified as personal protective equipment, and there are respirators that they have both certification, personal protective equipment and medical device. So they have tested for splash resistance and resistance to bacteria. And we will have as well the respirators that they have carbon on it, which some marketing, they will say, okay, it's offer better protection from the pathogen, which is completely false. Don't buy this. The carbon, the only added value of the carbon is that it filters out gases and smell, nothing else. in case that you will decide to buy a face mask, do not waste your money buying surgical masks. It will offer you no protection, and in some cases, if you are in a contaminated environment, actually it can be dangerous because you will think that you are protected, but you are not. Actually, you are not. If you want to be protected, use respirators. Okay, N95 is sufficient, FFP2, unless you are really going close to a person who is sick, then it may be a better idea to use N99 or FFP3. Now, you will see both surgical masks and respirators that they claim that they have an antimicrobial coat that kills 99.9 of bacteria or 99.9 of viruses. It can be true. It can be true. Some manufacturers, they have it. They have a layer, three layers, and the external layer they have an antimicrobial substance which will kill bacteria, will kill fungus, will kill viruses. But it requires time. It's a contact kill, so it has to stay in contact with the substance and can be from 5 minutes to 1.5 hour, depending really the pathogen and what is the substance that they are using. It will be copper, it will be silver or other substances. So it's a combination of the antiviral solution and the pathogen, how long it will take, which is fine, not to contaminate the environment after you will remove it, or if you touch after the mask outside. But it does not offer any protection for the pathogens that they will pass through the filtration, because it's these solutions, they work on contact and require, as we said, at least 5 minutes up to 1.5 hour, depending on the pathogen. Until now in the world, there was no, except one, there was no solution, antiviral solution on face mask that it can disactivate envelope viruses as they pass through. So even if they will pass the filtration mechanism, they will go inside, still you're gonna be safe. There was only one solution, one technology from a Swiss startup, but 3-4 years ago they stopped the production and is not available. But it was the only one until now that has offered such protection. And I want to finish, just before finishing, to show one more picture here. This is the head of the epidemiologist of WHO, who was leading the team that they went last month in China, and they came out with the report how good China has managed to save lives and manage the whole crisis. And as you see here, he's wearing a surgical mask. He's an epidemiologist. He knows that this one does not offer any protection. He's not wearing it because he knows that he will protect it. He knows that offers no protection. He's wearing properly the mask because he's obliged by law. In China nowadays, you have to wear the mask. It can be this one reason. Another reason as well, but it can be, it's they're just giving a subliminal message, is, the people, you need to wear protections. We are in danger, so you need to be protected. But he's in in the epicenter of the disease, and he's not wearing a respirator. Okay, such a VIP person, if he was really contagious and dangerous, this virus that they are telling us, he will have respirator. No doubt about that. See the doctors and the nurses in the ICU, where is the contagious person? Always they are wearing respirators, never a surgical mask. Surgical mask they will wear if the person is weak, so they want to protect him from what will come out from the wearer, but not the other way. So this is, he's creating false impressions. First of all, he's creating the impression that, you need to wear a face mask to be protected from this dangerous, deadly virus, but he's there and he's not wearing the right mask. False message. Or simply he's wearing it, he's not afraid of anything, and simply because it's by law, which is okay, respect this. Okay, you have to wear it, and any type, does not require respirator or surgical mask. But you see, pay attention, now you know, this kind of mask, they don't offer protection. And if you see authorities wearing this one, they just acting. It's an act. If you don't believe me, okay, go and wear this surgical mask. Or do your research. Do your research to find out. Don't believe me what I told you. Okay. But if you have if it resonates and if you think that it's true, and then you do your investigation and you find out that it's true, then share this information, save your money, do not buy surgical masks, buy, if you need to buy, buy respirators. N95, N99, FFP2, FFP3, P2, P3, DS1, DS2, DS3 in Japan. Okay, have a great day, and until the next video, stay healthy and do your investigation always. Have a good day.